Let's program up a routine for setting a matrix to the identity matrix. We start on the dashboard. We scroll down. We open up Set to Identity. Remember to first copy. And what we're going to do is write a Set to Identity routine. Now we'll just scroll down and I'll just let you read this on your own. Let's make this a little bit smaller so you can see the algorithm. You can see most of it here. And the idea is that we're going to write this right here. Now, to write the routine, we're going to use two functions available to us. One is the lav0v function, which we've already seen when we set a matrix to 0. And the other one is the lav1v, which sets a vector of numbers to all ones. And we're actually going to use it to set a scalar to 1. Of course, a scalar is a vector of size 1, so that should work just fine. So, I'm going to open up the Spark web page in a new browser, in a new window. I'll put this over here, and I'll just reset the form because I want to start over. And I'll move this over, and I'll put the algorithm right here so that I can have a look at it. And the function name should be set_to_identity, all lowercase, I believe. And I want an unblocked algorithm. We're going to look at two different implementations, so we'll call this variant number 1. It's only one operand. And actually everything else is set up correctly because we're going to update matrix A. And we're going to march through it from the top left to the bottom right. And it's both input and output, and it's flame pie, so all is looking good. So let's just look at the code that was generated, the code skeleton. And notice that this looks remarkably like the algorithm on the left. And you want to sort of double check that. The kinds of things you want to look at is to make sure that this says top left, and that this here says that the top left is equal to 0, and things like that. That just means that you march through the matrix in the correct direction. You then highlight, cut, copy, go bring it over here, plug it into insert code here. And then if you look here, you notice that you need to set a01 to the 0 vector, alpha11 to the scalar 1, and A21 to the 0 vector. And the way we're going to do that is to say lav.0 vector for A01. That sets that vector to 0. Lav.1 vector, that sets a vector to 1, but actually it's a scalar 1,1 that we're going to set to 1 with it. And finally lav.0 vector of A21. And bingo, we're done. We execute this box and we test by creating a square matrix A and then setting it to the identity. And it all works. So you're going to go and now implement the same thing, except you're going to march through the matrix in the same way, but you're going to set it to the identity one row at a time. I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. And now I'm going to show you how to do this. And the way you do this is you go back to the Spark web page. And now you indicate that this is variant number 2. You actually march through the matrix in exactly the same way. You pick this up and cut and paste it in. Insert it into the code box. The only catch now is that while before you had this, let's just put in what we had before, a01 lav.0.1v of alpha11 lav.0v of a21. Now that meant that we were setting this to 0, the a01 part of the matrix, then the alpha11 to 1 and then a to 1 to the 0 vector. What we're going to do instead is we're going to set this particular row to the correct values. And all that means is that here we pass in a01t. The t comes from the fact that it's a part of a row, and therefore we should think of it as a column vector transposed. And this right here we replace with a12t. Okay. We execute this box. We test it. Okay. And if we now go and we take the first algorithm, let's cut and paste this into PictureFlame. Okay, all I'm going to do here is I'm going to highlight everything in this box and then paste, and that overwrites it. So here now is my algorithm. If I click next, I see the algorithm on the left, and I can't see my matrix, so I'm going to make this a little smaller. Ah, there we have it. And if I now keep clicking next, you'll see that I march through the matrix and that matrix is set to the identity one column at a time. Now, and just kind of watch what's highlighted in red to see what operation is happening. And we're done. If, on the other hand, we go back and we pick up the second algorithm, and we overwrite this algorithm with it, and we click next, we get the new algorithm on the left. And if we keep marching through it, what you will see is that A is being set to the identity one row at a time. And we're done. If you want to see it again, click in this box, come back here, and you just start all over again with a new matrix. All right. So, what you've now learned is how to use the Spark web page to create a matrix that marches through a sort of a quadrants.